Every part of your body has its own consciousness or its own soul. These transformative words spoken by Indigenous medicine women began my journey within to discover the extraordinary healing capacity of the human body. Hey everybody, Daniela Langford here, founder and head coach at ReDYLF, Redesign Your Life Forever. And you are joining me today on a little walk around my neighborhood to talk about health. Health issues are among the top struggles that stand in the way of a conscious, joyful, fulfilled life to be had by the members in this group. And I would say arguably, people all over the world. When this perspective, this quote, was introduced to me, I was suffering from severe heart palpitations. Highly stress-induced, highly. I suddenly imagined incorporating this concept into my meditation routine. Call it divine intervention, right? I thought, can my body hear me? Can I talk to it to gain its cooperation in healing this condition? Can I really? So that night, after reaching a deep state of calm through, you know, meditation like you do, I inwardly engaged my body in a heartfelt conversation with hope, but no expectations. So after only about approximately 15 minutes of this focused communication, something amazing happened. My chest, my heart, it began to unclench. Now, my body was responding. How amazing. I couldn't believe it. Now, normally, I would have powerful, uneven heart rhythms just come and go at the drop of a hat. You may be familiar with this. Sometimes even just sitting reading, essentially just doing nothing. It would feel like my heart was going to explode out of my chest and up my neck. It just pound, pound, pound. Many doctors just couldn't figure it out. They were like, no, you're fine. You're fine. No EKG. We can't figure it out. But as I sat there for the first time in years, my chest began to release. The pressure let off and my heart was holding a steady beat. And I realized finally that the path to the freedom from this condition may have actually just begun. So as I continued to make progress with this condition, I organized an approach into a system that I could teach and share to my clients. I knew all too well how prevalent chronic pain is in this country, just alone, not mention the world, and wondered what the implications of this experience could mean to so many others who are suffering. So, ooh, got a lot of nice today. Nice and warm today. So today I'm gonna share with you those three key steps to gaining the cooperation of your body in healing. Now, with my new clients, I explain that regular meditation is necessary to train the brain. You want to enter that alpha theta brainwave states, which you may be familiar with, where the communication between the conscious mind and the physical body is dramatically enhanced. The veil is dropped. And we practice this together. So once you've gotten familiar with your own meditative state, my first tip is going to be approach your body with genuine compassion. Understanding that it too is made up of conscious cells who experience emotions just like the totality of you does. So as without, so within. Even your body has feelings and it knows when you hate it. The energetic vibration of hate has indeed been shown to twist DNA tighter, twist, 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 making it incapable of healing itself. Second tip to keep in mind is to build trust by engaging your body in mental conversations about your desire for cooperation to overcome the ailment. Imagine a wounded child who has been taught by his experiences not to trust. How would you begin that conversation to lead to loving cooperation? That's a way to go. And last but not least is the third tip to genuinely actually allow the changes in the conversation. Try different things. Try using different thoughts and words that elicit spontaneous elevated emotion when you get that trigger of happiness. Experiment how you communicate with yourself. A spike in emotion can be a place where your mental emotional body is intertwined with the physical and where it's holding in the sickness. So Use your feelings as a compass and don't be too rigid in how you expect to receive this communication, because as with everyone, it's all very personal and you just have to learn to listen in. So with these three tips in mind, as you begin to or continue your journey back to health, I can guarantee you, you will be building a better relationship with your body, which is a very, very immensely important factor in living your best life, which I'm sure you'll agree. So I know so many people who are struggling with various ailments that hold themselves hostage with the intentions and the self-talk that they hold about themselves. Oh, well, I'll always be sick. Oh, well, I'll never get rid of this. So if there's anything I want you to take away from this, is that intention is a very, very powerful tool that we can either use for our betterment or our detriment. And there's a great bit of science that I will be sharing with you in a little story time in this group that really opens up the proof, you know, so to speak, of how we're connected not only to each other, but to our own cells that make up this physical vehicle and intention's role in that. So look out for that. That's going to be a fabulous story time. But I know this, you know, just as well as anybody else, that it is so hard to get started on a new health journey for so many and for so many reasons. It batters you down, being physically ill. It wears at your mind, your emotions, your spirit, your connection to higher spirit. And I know so many people right now who have tried and tried and tried again to find healing, but I find that when I work with them, that the thing that they've neglected the most important part of the equation, is themselves. They've neglected themselves. So this is what I do all day long, bringing clarity to those people who have spent so long dealing with this overwhelming forest of pain and agony to see the beauty of the new opening leaf, the new opportunity. Clarity is personal power. And I find that one of the first things that people relinquish when facing a physical illness is that power. So if you've been fighting this battle and you're ready to try a different approach, something radical, cutting edge, spiritual science, then I would love to have a conversation with you, because I've got 5 spaces left with me this week, free to talk to you. And this is serious. I am here to bring this out. Let's find what beautiful butterfly of clarity that you've been missing. What have you been neglecting about yourself in this healing process? What have you forgotten getting into the cycle of being stressed and overwhelmed by the forest of what you're going through? We as human beings are not meant to live in perpetual anguish and chronic pain and anxiety and poor health. We're not. We are the spark of life. And vibrancy is 100% achievable to those ready to take that radical look at what is actually contributing to their condition. So click on that link in the comments or message me directly. Your body is listening. Are you ready to love it back to health? Comment below with your experiences. I always love to hear from you. This is Daniela of ReDYLF, and thank you for joining me on my walk. Let us set you free.